Hi, welcome to the second part of the video on how to choose among pooled OLS regression model, fixed effects model and random effects model. In the earlier video, you saw the estimation of the three models and then I performed Hausman test, and the basis of Hausman test I concluded that fixed effects model is better than the random effect model. Now here is my fixed effect model, and these are the results. You see C1 is the coefficient of the regression, the constant. C2 is the coefficient of the study time. C3 is a coefficient of dummy for the second student. C4 is the coefficient of the dummy for the third student, and C5 is the coefficient of the dummy for the fourth. Now here the constant of regression is significant, the coefficient of study time is significant, the coefficient for the second of the dummy for the second student is not significant, and same is the case for the coefficient of the dummy for the third student. However, the coefficient of the dummy for fourth student is highly significant. So in fixed effect model, basically each cross section has its own intercept, and it accommodate the heterogeneity. Now since my Hausman test shows that I should use a fixed effect model, I should also check whether fixed effect model will be appropriate or common effects model will be appropriate. So I will use the wall test. So press view and coefficient diagnostic, and then wall coefficient restrictions. The coefficients for my three dummy variables are C3 is equal C4 is equal C5 is equal 0. Now I want to test this, whether the coefficients of these dummies are jointly equal to 0. So I will press OK, and you know, here this is the wall test p value that equal to 0.0635. Now let me remind you that the null hypothesis was that common effects model is better, and the alternative hypothesis was that I should use fixed effects model rather than the common effects model. So this p value is higher than the p, so I will not reject my null hypothesis. So my conclusion is that instead of using either random or fixed effects model, I should better use pool OLS regression or the common effects model. So my final model will be pool OLS regression. So I once again will run it. This is the equation box, grade, constant, study time, and in the panel option I will not change this, because pooled OLS regression model is better than the fixed, whereas fixed effect model was better than the random effects model. So I will estimate pool, and this is the output of the pooled OLS regression or the common effects regression. Now coefficient of the constant is 34.2, the regression coefficient for the study time is 4.2, and this is highly significant. The explanation is that if the student increases study time by 1 hour on daily basis, his score will increase by 4.2. And R squared of this model is 93%, meaning that 93% of the variation in grades of the student is explained by the study time only. 7% of the variation is unexplained. F statistic is equal to 146.6. Its p value is less than 5, so it means the overall model is significant. So this is how we perform WALT test for deciding whether common effects model is better or fixed effects model is better. So if the WALT statistics p value is less than 5, we will reject the null and will accept alternative. But since in this case the WALT test p value is greater than 5%, so we keep the null hypothesis and we conclude that common effects model is better than the fixed effect model. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening to me. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, kindly do subscribe to the channel and click on the icon bell so that you can get notification when I will upload my other videos in future. Thank you very much.